Time to spot a couple of musical celebrity mystery guests now, each worth 2 points. Suggs, I'd like you, Billy and Robin, to try and name the angry young-ish man in this clip. Okay, Suggs, for 2 points.
It was Lamar from Kejagoogoo.
Do you know who that is, Billy?
No.
I said so.
2 points for Suggs' team. Well done. Yeah. Slightly less hair. That was, of course, Lamar. Now, Tony, Beverly and Paul, who's this with Faith?
Well, I guess it would be nice.
You might have recognised the bum.
Good on the bum.
God, you're in with this.
Book. Yeah, that I think that has to be Hate from Step.
Well done, Paul. It was, of course, Hate from Step. Now, not far to go. That means the scores are Tony with 11 catching up, but Suggs still in the lead with 15 points. Back to the picture board now. Billy, will you please pick a number?
Number 8.
Noel Gallagher, I'll say on your behalf.
Okay.
It's close, but it's not right, I'm afraid.
Well, I can't give you a no, but I think it's the singer from the Ocean Colour scene.
It's the wrong answer. It is, in fact, Blur frontman Damon.
Damon, no way.
Oh, God.
Okay, Beverly, choose a number for us, please.
10.
Number 10.
Yeah, it could be. Look at the hair.
Yeah.
Look at the hair. Well, as good as anything. Go on.
Yeah, go on.
Peter Andre, maybe.
It's the right answer. Robin, pick a number for us, please. 1. Number 1. Prince.
Or the artist formerly known as we now got to call him.
Or is it the symbol?
One of them. All three.
It's the right answer. It is, of course. The artist formerly known as Prince. Okay, Paul, pick a number for us.
I'll go for 11.
But then I'll tell her twice.
Oh, God. Well, Jerry Halliwell, possibly. When she was younger, a little girl, slightly thin through.
2 points. Well done. Okay, Chance. Two numbers left. Which is it to be?
Number 4, please.
Number 4.
Yeah.
I'm not going to blame Billy. If it's right, it's my answer. It's Mel G, Scary Spice.
Is the right answer.
Yeah, yeah. It is, of course, Mel G. Yeah, yeah.
It's tell you what, number six looks fantastic. I love number six, please. Cheers.
I'll be saying that now.
Oh, no.
You're 4 points behind. You could really do with this.
Yeah, I know.
Don't add any extra
pressure.
You don't
want to put any more pressure on me or anything.
No more pressure,
like,
but pretty vital.
No. I ain't got a clue.
I've
got to tell you, I ain't got a
clue.
Look at this face, it says nothing.
Suggs, any idea who that is?
Yeah, I've got an idea. It's Ian McCulloch from Echo and the Bunnymen.
Is the right answer. One round to go. The scores are Tony's on 15, Suggs is steaming ahead with 21. Sort you out with some frantic on the buzzer pop trivia now. 1 point for a correct answer. Questions answered wrongly will not be given to the other team, but be warned, an incorrect answer and I'll deduct 1 point. The round ends when you hear the crashing cymbal. Fingers on your buzzers, off we go. Who went to number one flying without wings in 1999? Billy.
Westlife.
Is a right answer. Which song was a Christmas number one for Michael Jackson? Paul.
Earth song.
Is correct. Well done. Well, who shot into the charts firing rubber bullets?
10cc.
Tony, correct. Gary Barlow's first solo single, Forever Love, entered the charts in which position? Billy.
Number one.
Is the right answer. Whose first top 10 hit was Your Song? Tony.
Elton John.
Correct. Who wrote Words, which became a hit for Boyzone?
Oh,
Billy.
No.
Yeah, I know.
Words.
Boys and words.
Hello.
No conferring. No, it was in fact the Bee Gees. So I'm lucky. Glad to see you're still with us, Robin. Okay,
it wouldn't be
who
correct
wrote
to answer
Chain
that.
Reaction for Diana Ross? Is the right answer. Whose genie in a bottle went to number one? Billy.
Christina Aguilera.
Is correct. Where in London did the Kinks watch the sunset?
Waterloo.
Is yes. The right answer. Well, after that final round, the scores are Tony's team have 19 points, but this week's winners with 24 points is Suggs' team. To team captains, Suggs and Tony Hadley, and my eternal gratitude to Billy, Robin Gibb, Beverly Knight and Paul from S Club 7. Hope you enjoyed the show enough to make us go straight to number one. We'll see you in the spring for some more Questions of Pop. Good night.